Hi, and welcome to week 8 of Magoos Corner. I'm your host, Trevor Gregg, joined by Daniel McKenna. How are you, mate?
Going very well, Trevor. Very well. Just really hitting my straps.
It's been a good night, honestly. And, you've got to click on all of them to understand what I'm going on about, because we've gone backwards. We've gone 6-1 this week. But, yeah, have a look at it. Even if you don't know anything about those clubs, have a good bloody look. It's good.
I certainly know nothing about any of these clubs, Trevor, so...
I don't think anybody would tell. I don't think anybody could tell.
I'm certainly not here for my football expertise. I'm just here to provide comic relief, mate. That's it.
And the first game of the week, I called this one the match of the round, which was Henley taking on Goodwood Saints at Henley Memorial Oval, and it was Henley getting the job done, 7-8-50 to 7-7-49. So Henley getting just a win by a point, which is massive for me.
Yep. Henley, very good outfit, very good club, strong club, as are Goodwood Saints as well. I just think the lower grades at Henley are probably above Goodwood Saints. Mm. Not a real surprise, more so how low scoring and how tight it is, rather than Henley actually coming away with a win.
Yeah, and Henley do have quite a few young lads playing each week.
Yeah, I see that Dale Simmons, definite A-grade starter, even playing B-grade out there.
Joel Chapman got a gig this week.
Yeah.
Coming from Woodville South, wants to play a high grade of footy, so good on him for giving it a crack. And I wonder if Scotty from out at Goodwood Saints picked on anybody his own size this week, so I hope you did that, champion. So now we've got, for Henley, goal scorers, Clark with 3, Travis Natt still getting into the goal scorers, Rayson, Rowley and Davidson. I don't really think there's anybody that can go with Nat at the minute, since he's made the move from districts. It's been a good move. Best players was Martin, Rex, Clark, Coates, Sheepers and Bellingham for Henley.
Yep, good to see Dylan Coates getting in the best players there. Yeah, good young bloke. Best players for Goodwood were Crook old game.
It is a Crook old game.
Crook, Frost, Johnston, Bryce and Donald.
Just Donald.
And goal kickers there were A good with 3 and the rest were all single.
He kicked a good goal 3.
He's kicked a good 3 goal.
So very good to Henley. We move on to the next one, which this one was a little bit surprising, but it was Paynham Nord Union hosted Salisbury North and Paynham got the job done. 12-15-87 to 5-3-33.
Yeah, a bit surprising there. It's Salisbury North normally have a pretty decent B grade as well, but Paynham are really strengthening as a club overall, so they're just getting away with them.
Yeah.
A's and B's.
Do you want to take Paynham or Salisbury?
No, I'll take Salisbury.
Okay,
good. Goal kickers for Salisbury were Clark, Motley, Lawler and Victor. Bit surprising to see Motts in the B's there, normally an A grader, but anyway. Best players were Victor, McBride, Slaughter, Malroney and Trini Pascoe.
And for Paynham Nord it was Sampson with 3, Agarastis with 3, Manone, Stringer, Costanzo, sorry mate, Charlton, Murison and Wonky. And best players was Savalas, Edwards, Wonky, Chatsagiannis, and Virgilio getting in there as well, so very, very good.
what's the setup now, you know, obviously, at Paynham? How many sausage rolls is Nick Jolly knocking off at half-time? He's kicking a few, but how many is he eating? Is he going one a goal? Because it looks like he's going one a goal.
He does look like he's going one a goal, but he is definitely one of those big men that just absolutely surprises you. If he was to go into the ruck, he'd rove his own taps.
Oh.
He is very quick underneath his knees. Because it's very quick.
Two buses and a train to get around him, mate. Have you seen the size of him?
Exactly. So it's just one of those things. You could be, I think the only person that would be Dustin Fletcher.
Mate, when he goes and buys his jeans, he's literally got to get out the pie method and times his waist by 3.14. He's that big, mate. I tell you what,
they and just
does his shopping for jackets down at the bloody Rays outdoors. Just puts a tarp over himself. He's a big boy.
He is a massive unit, and he was offered plenty of money at the start of the year to go elsewhere, but he's very loyal to to George Macca and the boys out there, but I think Paynham are going to surprise quite a lot of people above them, which would be really, when you have a look at it, as in Goodwood Saints, Roz, Trevor, those types of teams, they're going to get a rude shock, and I do believe that they'll be in the mix later on in the year.
Nick Jolly and his little mate Tommy Javor nearly got the producer and I kicked out of the cricket one day, where they tried their best, but
is that on the hill near the side screen? Is that down that end?
Yeah, it's down that end. Yep.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah. Big game that one, was it?
No, I just remember the stories about it. So luckily these things can be edited. Moving on to the next one.
Joel Pattinson was the one that actually kicked us out of the game, the actual cricketer.
Oh, so. That's right. Yes. No, because he copped a fair lip, didn't he?
Not fair enough, I didn't think.
No, he didn't. That was when he was in his form, so I wanted to kick in a bloke while he's doing it. So moving on to the next one. It was obviously our lads hosting Port District Support Reserve. It was definitely a game that we wanted to really have a crack at, but it was... Our depth has been really, really tested. We've had a lot of injuries, and we're relying on the wrong type of people and players to be able to fill those voids in a Division One club. So, in saying that, you're up in a couple of weeks, aren't you? But you've got to take your hat off to the people that actually do want to get out there and lend a hand. And this is why I feel rather strong about Kilburn and the B grade, Gipps Cross as well. So just it's not where we all just get in a circle and sing Kumbaya and try and make ourselves feel better. It's our depth is really being tested at the moment. So the buyers come at a really, really good time for us. But best players was Tyson Royal playing his second senior game, and under 18. Damien Leonard got second best this week. Matty Dutram, Sean Hughes, and Max Buckley, another under 18.
Damien Leonard in the best players. It's a bit of a not so sure about your selection there, mate.
I'm not playing favourites. It was the Big Fist's best game, even though he said, look, he's geared up for a good one. Wasn't happy about a picture that's been put on the Portland website, the Facebook one. I don't know if you saw that. Not happy with it.
Very just in Nick Jolly mould, isn't he?
He is, but just that way. Sorry, Damo. Goal kickers Dutram with 3. Did the change. Coaching, I wouldn't say brilliance, it was just a coaching move. Put him up forward and got a free kick. And the districts, I think it was, I won't do it, I won't put him in there. But mouthed off to the umpire and got a free kick straight after the first goal was kicked. So Dutram kicked his second and then his third within a few minutes. So it was a fair effort for our fullback, just trying something different. James Rickney, Morgan Evans, Leonard also chipped in, and he will let you know and everybody know about his bounce through the middle on two occasions.
Heard it already.
You've already heard it. How many bounces did he have?
Two within about 3 metres. He just claimed an extra bounce there.
I heard stories that he was telling people that it was 7 by the time it got to 7:30.
He's telling people it was Mick McGowan while he took 25. Best players for Port Districts were Quinn, O'Neill, Elliot, Traeger. And Parker, goal kickers were Traeger, Parker, Martin, Quinn, O'Neill, Brett Pryor, apparently.
He's got back.
We're tracking all districts. Ricky Wiseman and B. Bryant.
That's surprising. Ricky Wiseman, from what I believe, was saying that it's just going back there to play with mates in the C grade or something. I don't know 100%, but hardly played any of the game and then left halfway through the last quarter. But to be honest, is it Jake O'Neill, number 17, absolutely brilliant. You take him out of the game, and even Quinn also played a very good game, but you take O'Neill out of the game in that reserve side, you'll be in very good stead later on in the game. He's a very smart footballer.
Jake
can run.
Jaden. Yes, Jesse. I played juniors with the Jesse O'Neill out there, but I'm not sure it's him.
Yeah, very good player. Good work to districts, and nice of the coach to come up and shake hands after the game too.
Who is that?
Don't know, I don't care. Sacred Heart took on Ross Trevor, out of Sacred Heart, and Sacred Heart just keep on going. And they got 13-8-86 to Ross Trevor's 9-4-58, so a predicted score, I just can't see Sacred Heart faltering at the minute.
Yeah. If only their A grade could sort of pick up on their winning ways and sort of
whatever they had to swap over when we played.
Possibly. But no, best players for Ross Trevor were Bowler, Versace, Noel, Kitson, Du Bois, and Deegan. Goal kickers were Richter and Sermon with two, and the rest were singular.
I think that was the guy that Damien called the sphincter last week. Sacred Heart, Domenico with four, it's popping up again. Jordan with four, Vasari, Angling, Taylor, Potts, and Maroney. And best players, of course, were Domenico, Jennings, Button, Vanille, and Vasari. So nice work there to Sacred Heart, and they'll really enjoy the break, and I think they'll just keep on going and running even harder next after the bye's taken. So it was Adelaide Uni taking on Tea Tree Gully. This was closer than what I thought it would be. At Uni Oval, it was 8-5 to 8-7. Tea Tree Gully getting the job done by 2 points.
Yeah, I thought Tea Tree Gully would have taken that out by a bit more than that, but must have good fight by Adelaide Uni. So well done to them. Best players for Tea Tree Gully were Popke, Wilson, Doyle, Jive. Oh, my eyes are shocking. Jelfs and Penny. And goal kickers were Daniels with four, Thompson with two, Robinson and Wilson with one apiece.
And Adelaide Uni, Bateman kicked four. You got Offie, Charlie, Green, Connell getting in the goal scorers. Bateman, Dolan, Peniment, Green, Offie, and Pittman getting in the best players. So, pardon me, very close game. So looking at the ladder now, we've got Sacred Heart undefeated on top. And I'm not going to say they'll go undefeated all year, but they will pretty much remain there and be a very tough ask for most sides. Henley take out at number two at the moment. And then third is Ros Trevor at 5-2. Goodwood Saints, now that is surprising, at 4-3. And they're only at 61% also, whereas last year they were very, very strong, obviously, and had very good percentage. Paynham, 4-3. Adelaide Uni, 3-4, same as Port Districts. Tea Tree Gully, 2-5. That is still very surprising also. And Salisbury North, now I don't know who they had in round one, but they just seemed to bring everybody out when they took us on and gave us a flogging, which is pretty much close to what's been happening most of the year. But they seem to be a very different side at the moment, sitting in ninth, and then ourselves on the bottom with 0-7. So I will not beat Tommy's record of 0-18, that's for sure. He said he took Payne's money and ran. He didn't care what anybody thought. He just wanted the money to coach, and that was it. He said he didn't care if they were 0-72. He would still take their money. But it's been very, very different. And looking after the bye, we've got Ros Trevor taking on ourselves on Campbelltown Oval.
Oh, I think we're going to win.
Very good. Very, very good. Goodwood Saints take on Adelaide Uni at Goodwood Oval.
Goodwood Saints for mine.
I think the smaller oval will hurt
Adelaide Uni. Just can't. They don't seem to adapt well to the smaller ovals, where they can't get a running game going. So I think they'll struggle out there.
So yeah, I think Goodwood will get the job done, just to creep back up there. Port Districts take on Henley at Large Reserve.
Henley will find something for that. Henley will win that.
I hope Henley do it and do it really, really, really well. So, Tea Tree Gully take on Payne and Norwood Union at Petteringa Oval.
Payne and Norwood too strong there.
Yeah, I think they will be. I think Payne will get the job done quite easily. And Salisbury North take on Sacred Heart at Salisbury North Oval.
Sacred Heart for me.
Sacred Heart by plenty for me. So that's the Division 1 reserves for this week. Make sure you subscribe to the SA Footballer magazine, and we'll catch you again next week.